those folks. It's not near to being over. I don't even think we may be closing in on the beginning of the ending of the beginning, but that's about it. We'll find out more from George and Cliff in just a couple of minutes. Halfpasthuman.com is their website. Absolutely fascinating material. And I might also add that their material has been, shall we say, borrowed by more than a few people on the Internet.
And also, let's mention Urban Survival. That's yes. Where we have our free public writing on the material.
All right, we'll do that in just a minute. Stand by. Okay, and back with George and Cliff. Where were we, George? I think you were finishing up a point, weren't you?
Yeah, sort of. I mean, in many ways, Jeff, the period ahead looks like it will be the delayed start of the Second Great Depression, or as a friend of mine calls it, the Greater Depression, because we really should have slid into it in the wake of the Internet bubble bursting. And from a policy standpoint...
Now, that's interesting. You're talking about the dot-com crash?
Oh, sure.
Okay. But what kept us from going in then? How did they keep this dead man up walking?
Yet another bubble.
Uh-huh.
And,
yeah,
and we've
exactly.
seen the bubbles grow, and it's kind of an inverse pyramid. A small bubble must always mathematically lead to a larger bubble in order to subsume its problems. And eventually you get to the point where we're at now, where the largest possible bubble has been created, derivatives.
One quadrillion worth.
Correct. We cannot create any other bubble. The second largest bubble was the global housing boom that occurred in the developing countries. And it's just an issue of the Kondratov wave and what they had to do to try and derail it. And they were even talking about, we could have fixed the previous depression if we'd only had $5 billion to recapitalize the bank. All would have been well and good. Question is, where do you get real money these days, especially when you've created all these huge bubbles and the whole world is dependent upon it?
The real structural problem right now, Jeff, is that this $700 billion, which really seems like I can't find a limit to it. It's like
It's 850 on paper and
right.
$1.8 trillion in reality. It's one more massive insult to the American public, one more ripoff, one more theft before things get real ugly this winter. That's all it is.
Yeah, exactly. And having gotten to this point, we literally are on the verge of replaying the depression that happened in the 1930s. We got out of it. We skated. We should have had more severe problems on the backside of the Internet bubble, but the timing of 9/11 was such that the Bush administration was able to spin things into a general war on Islamic fundamentalism.
Right. The total fraud war on terror, the orchestration of 9/11, not the timing, if you'll go with me with that,
sure,
that far.
Sure, sure. But what that did is, see, that gave us a hell of a spending bump. That was like the Works Progress Administration.
Then they also changed policy, George, to back in that, and they created the situation where we had a shifting down of dollar rates for employment, and we had the large sucking sound as we pulled across hundreds of or millions of illegals in our country, which put housing pressure on the whole economy throughout the entire nation. We had immigration going as far north as the Canadian border and beyond, and the housing pressure was part of the whole boom.
35 to 40 million illegals now from over 70 different countries.
And they could all get loans from Freddie and Fannie.
Yep.
And free medical care for the most part.
Free education, free medical care, free food, free housing, you name it.
So it cut the basically the underpinning out from the social structure. It altered the social contract in many small towns. It changed things radically, and they did it in essence to keep the housing boom going in order to have that bubble go, which in turn supported the next bubble up, which was the collateralized housing obligations in all their plethora of plenitude and different forms.
Right, adjustable rate mortgages, of course, were incredibly metastasizing cancer that went along for a long time, and now it's everywhere.
The lawyers' loans, all of it. Yeah,
sure. And let's not forget realtors who were after that 6 or 7% commission. Let's not forget mortgage lenders. I'm getting there. Let's not forget mortgage lenders, and let's not forget their partners in crime, the appraisers. You know, I need an appraisal for X to get this loan made. Can you help me out? I mean, it's these people. It's a good old boys network all the way. I don't care where you are. It's who you know, and they wanted to keep this absolute deadly fiction completely spinning out of control, and they did. Now, my question about the derivatives market and the larger financial paradigm, which involves this entire collapse and catastrophe, how many people, approximately in round numbers, were involved with pulling all this off? And most of it was planned, if not all of it, to one degree or another. I'm going to say, 40,000-50,000 people out of $6.5 billion?
No, you can nail it down even tighter than that.
I'm being kind. Go ahead.
Yeah, I was saying it goes right down to the membership of the Bilderbergers.
I would pull it down, but I just want to keep people on the believable plane here.
Yeah.
Yes, but you're quite right. We're talking about 5,000 people tops.
Yeah, and on the other side of that, those people that were culpable and involved were motivated by something other than knowledge of what was going on. And in that sense, they have their own karmic debt because they participated, just like a prison guard participates in abuses in an abusive system. But they may end up in that job because they're attempting something good in the sense of trying to support their family, etc. Now, there is greed all over, and everybody's going to end up paying for it.
Uh-huh.
But karmically, some people are going to end up getting an interesting little visit this future.
Well, Richard Fold, the former CEO of Lehman, you heard that last hour. I pulled that story up. Was punched out, knocked out cold in the Lehman Brothers gym after it was announced they were going down. Somebody came up. I'm surprised, frankly, given the number of people going postal in the last 10, 15 years, that we haven't seen some very violent...
not yet. We will. The language is very negative that way. We're going to see some...
Yeah, next summer.
No, it's going to even be earlier. Some of the newer release language is suggesting that we're going to have some kind of an incident in which maybe as many as 40 people will be shot on American soil. Who's going to do the shooting? I'm not really sure. It's not saying that it's military.
Well, there are a lot of people who are wiped out right now that are actually going to have to face living in their cars or living with relatives that formerly had mansions and all the rest of it.
Yeah.
And they're not real happy.
Stress is built,
Yeah, we have tent cities now popping up all over the United States.
Shrubberbs.
What are they called?
Shrubberbs or bush mills.
There you go. Yeah. I had a plan that I think many cities ought to consider, and that we've all seen many storage units put up with just cinder block construction, 10 by 15, 10 by 20. I think cities ought to actually... begin building these with an eye toward, in the future, running them as actual storage facilities for profit. But in the meantime, they should be made available to the truly homeless, give everyone a 10 by 20-foot space, 24-hour security in there with public restrooms and showers for people who truly are down and out. Then when this eventually mitigates, they could take these places and actually turn them into for-profit businesses run by cities and employ people. I mean, I don't see why that can't happen. Structure and shelter is structure and shelter, and those are very strong, sturdy buildings.
Yeah, but that's too complicated. I mean, look at the potential now that government is taking over Fannie and Freddie, 46% of mortgages. When those default, hey, we could end up with the government in the housing business directly, just like the Kremlin of 25 years ago.
Right. Well, going back to the Soviet.
Mm-hmm. And besides which, in our language, we see that the social contract is going to be shattered over these 5 months, and it won't make much difference. We'll get to a point in 2009 when people will be going along in a very abysmal state, see an empty McMansion, and say, hey, we're home.
And just take it.
They'll just come on in, and we'll have squatter rules. We're going to have warfare between the law enforcement, which is not to say peace officers, not police, law enforcement.
Well, they just make the laws to make it legal,
their actions, whatever they decide that they're going to do.
We know now that NORTHCOM has at its disposal one of the most deadly combat units that served in Iraq right here.
Yeah, I understand that, and that's been going around the net, but everybody needs to be appraised of the fact that that brigade is at less than full strength. And these guys are may indeed be battle-hardened, but they're also battle-weary, and it brings right back to the... Actually, it comes down to a question that we've seen in the data. The question is not, will the battle-hardened sons and daughters of the populace of the U.S. come home and kill their parents? Because we know that they have been trained to do just that, mm-hmm. and they've been shocked, and their brains have been tortured by the drugs and the experiences they've gone through in a way that none of us will ever really understand unless you go through it. But the real question is going to come in 2009 is, will those parents shoot those children after they have shot their neighbors?
Wow.
And it's coming to that.
Wow.
Now, that small brigade cannot garrison the United States. The United States cannot be garrisoned. China, the largest population on the planet, understands you cannot garrison an effectively without 20% of the population being in active cahoots with the oppressors. And this is true of the Roman Empire, any empire you've ever seen. So I don't see garrisoning occurring in the United States.
That's the formula.
States.
Well, we've got 300 million people and about, I don't know how many, several hundred million guns and so forth. It's not going to happen. They actually thank God for guns in this country, or it might be a different story. Without the ability to protect ourselves, this is the only thing really keeping these controllers from trying to somehow garrison. They're not going to be able to do it, but at least try to impose. I don't think martial law would work. Martial law would create an instant condition of general anarchy in most of the country.
And revolution, correct. It would just bring up the language almost instantly. Yes.
That's right. And the cops aren't going to go out and do it. They're going to be staying home taking care of their own families. It's just...
Or assigned to the institutions to protect them, and at that point... They're going to say, am I loyal to this bank? No, I'm worried about my family and that.
Can you imagine that, sending out cops to protect a bank in this kind of a situation? They're going to just say, forget it, I'm out of here.
Not all of them. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a serious problem that comes up too, Jeff, about when we talk about the threat to the social contract. Mm-hmm. Remember that as the currency is debased in order to pay for all the bailout stuff coming down the pipe.
Right.
Where are we going to get the money to pay the prison guards, the police, the firemen enough money in devalued paper so that they can maintain parity with their current living conditions?
And the worst
especially
thing, America. Go ahead, George. Cliff, go ahead.
I would say, especially when we're supporting a military in 190 countries around the world.
That's beyond belief what's going on.
Here, let's print some up for you, Jeff.
Yeah, we'll send it along.
Yeah.
I need some
Kindling. George, be sure and ship that package up to me, too.
Oh, yeah. No problem. 100.
All right. We'll be back.